wanted to lay a bit of the landscape of e-commerce in South Africa, and to start with sites like Mr. Price. Those are e-commerce stores that are built out of traditional retail brands, and those have got the benefits of brand credibility, of supply chain. The next would be sites like Kalahari, who are built within big corporates, and so they have the advantages of very deep pockets and long-term outlooks, and they have been around for a long time. They're probably some of the more ones we know about better. And then thirdly, you have sites like Zando's, and so these are the companies that start with a whole lot of money and they can launch with a huge bang, and on day three they have 200 employees, and I take my hat off to them. And so those are the first three. This is the fourth type of e-commerce, and that's me in my lounge. Not now, that was about 2006. And these are the people who start e-commerce with no money, and with no big brand, and with no supply chain, and with no marketing, and with no hype, but they're willing to work for nothing, and they're pretty passionate about what they do. And this is the story that I'm going to tell. I'm going to tell Yuppiechef's story from a lounge to where we are now. And it's not to say that we're better or worse than any of the other types of e-commerce, but we are different. And I hope that I can inspire and encourage other people who are also filling their lounges at the moment and wanting to step out. So this is Yuppiechef. That is the site. We sell kitchen tools, for those who don't know, and some food items. So how did we start? We were in web development, so we were selling our time by the hour. And everyone who's in that industry dreams of being able to not sell their time by the hour, to be able to be on the beach and to do 1 hour of work. You're willing to do it for free if you're going to benefit from it for, you know, the next couple of years. And that's the dream. But no one ever does it. So at the time, there were four of us working. This is in 2005. Another friend, John, and Shane is taking the photo. So the four of us who were working together at that time decided, well, we want to not sell our time by the hour. We want to launch a product. And so the four of us had to go away and come up with something that we were going to sell online, and then come and build a website. And we came together for Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and we each came with a product. And on the Thursday morning, we voted for which product it was going to be, and then we built the site. And we built it, we designed it, came up with a name, we found some couriers, we hooked up some payment method, and the site that we launched was Bugzapper. Has anyone seen the Bugzapper? That's exactly what we intended it to be. We wake up, well, actually, we only sold one on the Saturday, and that was to my mom, because we forgot about marketing. And 2005, marketing online was pretty tricky, particularly with no budget. But it slowly got off the ground, and it became exactly what we wanted it to be. It was we could build something on the site that you could go away, and you could come back the next day, and you could make some sales, and you put them in the box, and you ship them out. So we were on this journey of, ooh, we've got the e-commerce bike, and we're going to start lots of sites, because we know how to do it now. And then we came across the idea for Yuppiechef, and Yuppiechef was in 2006, and Shane went away and he came up with the concept of selling kitchen tools online. And when we started getting to Yuppiechef, we realized we actually don't want to start lots of these sites. We want to start one and do it properly and really build the brand. And there's a great story about the name Yuppiechef, the brand, because Yuppiechef.com was already taken by someone else at the time. But Shane was so convinced that this is the name that it has to be, that we emailed the guy who owned the domain and said, you want to sell it to us, and we didn't hear a response, so it was a bit disappointing. And then about a month later, we were on the site, we were looking up some domains for a client, and changed out to Yuppiechef.com, and they let it expire, and we bought it for $9. So that is the story of our name, and then we knew it was right. And this was the first design, well, the oldest design that we have in record. It didn't go live, but that was just a still of it. You can see the logo and the name are pretty much what they are today. So this was in 2006, we were building it. And we launched in August 2006, and this was our very first sale. It's one based in Rush and a peeler, and that was to Shane's dad. So the legacy continued. This is all of the sales in 2006, and there are 11 of them. Actually, hang on, 8 of them. I got it wrong. There are none in December, because there were no sales in December 2006. And out of that list of 8 sales, only one of them was to someone we didn't know. You know, a non-family member or friend. A friend of a family member. And so it was about as slow a start as you can possibly have in business. We were not, certainly not making any money off this. We were still doing our day jobs, which was building websites for people, and we were slowly getting this off the ground. We launched with no credit card facilities, you can only pay with an EFT, and we would walk up the road to the stationery store at the end of the road and, you know, buy the packing tape and the handwritten card came in a silver envelope at that time, and walk back down and pack the one box. And at the time, this was sort of 2006, 2007, still very slow. And in beginning of 2008, my second son was new. And we would pack the boxes in a room that was just opposite where he slept. And this is a chat we have, so it's very small, so that community. Mike was our one employee at the time. He said, this is 2:38 p.m. Is it fine to use the tape now? So this is those packing tapes, you know, that you can I make 2:30 a sort of general rule? And this is because my son used to sleep in the afternoon. He would have a sleep between kind of 1 and 3. And the packing tape made too much noise. So in terms of cottage industry, kind of working from home, it's about as garage as you can get. It's about as kind of home industry as you can get. This is Shane packing a box. You can see the bugs at this actually in the bottom left of this picture because we're running both businesses at the same time. And Shane was cutting down that box because we didn't want to ship too much air because it kind of cost money to ship it. So you've got to make the box as small as you can to put the products in. We stamp the side, we put it in a box. And we built the systems as we went along. So at that time, we would, you know, one order a month or one order a week. Or you can remember it in your head and you email the supplier and say, please send me one of these things and they send it to you and you put it in the box. And Shane went away for a week, so I was in charge of packing the boxes. And there were like 3 orders at one time. And I thought, how are we going to cope? So I printed out each of the orders and I put a piece of paper on the desk and 3 bits of paper. And then as the stock came from the supplier, I put the stock on top of the bit of paper. And then when everything was right, I thought, hang on, this is going to change. So then we built the first bit of the kind of ordering system and the orders went green when they could ship. And that's how we've evolved over time. This was one of the very first boxes. And that on top is a silver envelope, which is the handwritten cards. We write handwritten cards to this day, which I'll come back to in a moment. And we try and make the packaging and the experience something nice. We had a lot of time, obviously, so we could package each other. In 2008, we moved to an office in Westlake Business Park, which is in Cape Town, southern suburbs. And at that stage, Paul, who's actually in the back, and Shane and myself and Sarah was in customer service, and Mike was in logistics. We didn't have 5 boxes on that day, so that's why he's holding 5. But this we're very proud of our team at that stage, 2008. This was the stock room. That was the stock. I really enjoyed this picture because the fact that it exists, I look back now and I think, why did I take a picture of those boxes? It could only be because we were like, wow! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 boxes? We also used to handwrite the labels on the boxes until the courier guys could no longer read the writing of Mike, who wasn't very good at writing, and so then we had to print the labels. So that's our story, and it's a story of great passion and desire to produce excellent experiences because we had nothing else. John Cherry, who some of you might know, he was consulting, big word, he was helping us at the time with our marketing, and he said, well, if you don't have any money, your best form of marketing is word of mouth. So just delight your customers and they'll tell lots of other customers. And we said, John, how many other customers can one customer tell? Like we've only ever had one customer, you know, that's going to take forever. But it was built into who we are from the beginning, was about delighting customers. And this is our Peter page, which unfortunately you can't see. We have 270 smiley faces and 2 unhappy faces. And those unhappy faces kill us. And we've done everything we can to try and turn those 2 unhappy people into happy people. We know them by name, and fortunately they drop off after a year. And I don't say that to boast, I don't say that to kind of, you know, make it sound like we're doing anything spectacularly good, but it's something that we focus very hard on. As a point of reference, and this is mostly because it's very funny, this is Hello Peter's page on Hello Peter. And they have 172 smileys and 171 unhappy faces. And most brands are kind of, if they go 50-50, they're doing quite well. And it's, I mean, there's lots of measures of how customers are doing. This is one of the more public ones. And it defines who we are, it defines how we started the business. And pretty much the only thing we can do to differentiate ourselves from everyone else who's got bigger budgets, more money, better supply chains, is that we can care. And that's something which is difficult for, no one can really replicate caring with money. You can only replicate caring if it starts, if it's built into the DNA of the business. I ran through a few of our proud moments, and I'm proud of them, not because necessarily they were spectacular, but because if you remember where we came from, they kind of take on a bigger meaning. This was when we helped Disney launch Tangled, the movie Tangled, the Rapunzel movie in South Africa. So because there was a frying pan in the movie, they thought we would be useful people to help them promote it. And we filled up theaters around the country, and people bought their old frying pans, and then someone could win a new frying pan. And it was just great that Disney, you know, Disney, like, people from America would want to work with us, Yuppiechef, to launch a movie. So that was great. This was, everyone bought a Mini during last year, like Mini the car, would get a gift from us. And what was great about this was that Mini wanted to send a Yuppiechef product and a Yuppiechef voucher as a gift. And it was just a great brand association that they would want to be associated with us. And we were a gift that was worth giving. This is quite funny, the Woolworths in the room, I'm sure a lot of you know the Woolies Lovebirds moment and us hijacking their domain. And what resulted from that was raising 100,000 Rand for Soil for Life, the charity that we support, and winning a gold lorry, which was, apparently it's a big deal. We're not an agency, so we kind of were a little bit in the dark about how big a deal it really is. But those are some great moments for us, and there's lots more. But it's really, we're proud of kind of the journey that we've come from over the years. This is us today. We operate from Westlake Business Park. We've got an office and a warehouse. We've got a whole lot more boxes than we used to have. We ship out more than that. We've got real stock on the shelves, lots of shelves. We had to stock take this last weekend, and there was a lot to count. We still ship the boxes in the way that we did. We still handwrite cards with people that we employ full time to do that, and part time, and we chip in when there's too much volume. And we take great pride in that experience. The only experience you have with the Yuppiechef is the box that arrives, and probably the delivery guy. So we've got to make that as personal and as human as possible. We have a warehouse with conveyor belts. That was a great day when we got our first conveyor belt. Something kind of big and grown up. A forklift and a conveyor belt are the two things that make you feel like a real man. We've launched our first Yuppiechef branded product, so it's a Leverkusen cookie set. So it's kind of a cookie cutter, but you can put letters in it and you can make your name on them. So this is, it's a Yuppiechef product, and it's kind of no one else's brand, it's our brand. And so those are the very first baby steps in that direction. This is our team. We've got about 55 people, and we do everything from one place. We're all in one big building, and we believe in that. We're going to continue that for as long as we can, so that the people packing the boxes are right next door to the people who are helping customers and the people who are writing the content. So we feel that helps with our culture and our vibe. This is a little bit more stats. We've got 5,000 tools, we're 6 years old, and we're hiring particularly the developers.